The human body is a complex system of organs, tissues, and cells that work together to maintain health and wellness. Among these systems, the gut microbiota stands out as a critical player in promoting optimal health. This diverse community of microorganisms includes bacteria, fungi, viruses, and other microbes that reside in the gastrointestinal tract and play a critical role in human health. In this video, we will explore the role of gut bacteria diversity in promoting optimal health and how it works within the gastrointestinal tract. Before we begin exploring the intricate world of gut bacteria diversity and its impact on our health, we kindly ask for your support by liking and subscribing to our channel. Your support helps us create more informative content like this, and we are grateful for your help. Let's now dive into the fascinating topic of gut bacteria and its vital role in promoting optimal health. How it works within the gastrointestinal tract. The gastrointestinal tract is the primary site of interaction between the gut microbiota and the host. The gut microbiota and immune system are closely interconnected, with lymph cells, T cells, B cells, and other immune cells all playing a critical role in regulating gut health. The gut epithelium also behaves as a barrier that prevents harmful substances, such as toxins and bacteria, from leaking into the bloodstream. And when this barrier is compromised, it can lead to a range of health problems. Intestinal epithelial cells, IECs, are specialized cells that line the gastrointestinal tract and play a critical role in maintaining gut health. IECs sense the presence of bacteria in the gut and interact with immune cells to help regulate the immune response. In addition, certain cells, such as dendritic cells and macrophages, stay next to the lining of the gastrointestinal tract and sense what's going on inside the gut with the bacteria, determining whether it's good or bad bacteria. These cells send signals to the immune cells to let them know what is happening in the gut. The role of T-reg cells in regulating good and bad bacteria in the gut. One key component of the immune system is T-reg cells, which help to regulate the balance between good and bad bacteria in the gut. T-reg cells are specialized T cells that play a critical role in maintaining immune tolerance and preventing autoimmunity. If there is not a good amount of bacteria variety, there may not be enough regulation produced by T-reg cells, and the immune system may begin to destroy the good bacteria. The importance of starting a good bacteria diversity at an early age. Starting a good bacteria diversity at an early age is important, as it can help to establish a healthy gut microbiome and prevent the development of various diseases and disorders. Infants acquire their gut microbiota primarily from their mother during birth and breastfeeding, and the composition of the gut microbiota changes over time as the infant grows and develops. Diseases caused by low diversity of beneficial bacteria. A low diversity of beneficial bacteria can contribute to the development of several health conditions, such as inflammatory bowel disease, IBD, obesity, and mood disorders. IBD is a chronic inflammatory disorder of the gut that is characterized by the presence of gut inflammation, intestinal barrier dysfunction, and increased gut permeability. Obesity is also associated with dysbiosis and increased gut permeability, which can contribute to systemic inflammation and the development of metabolic syndrome. Mood disorders, such as depression and anxiety, have also been linked to dysbiosis and altered gut-brain axis function. The importance of a balanced immune system. A balanced immune system is also important for optimal health, with a good immune system behaving like a well-oiled machine, capable of detecting and fighting off harmful pathogens while maintaining tolerance to beneficial bacteria and other harmless substances. A balanced immune system is achieved through a complex interplay between the gut microbiota, immune cells, and other body systems. Postbiotics and their role in healing the lining of the gastrointestinal tract and managing leaky gut syndrome. Postbiotics are metabolic byproducts of the gut microbiota that have biological activity and can influence host health. Short-chain fatty acids, SCFAs, are one type of postbiotic that is produced by the gut microbiota during the fermentation of dietary fiber. SCFAs have been shown to have anti-inflammatory and immunomodulatory effects and can help to heal the lining of the gastrointestinal tract. SCFAs may be a useful strategy for managing leaky gut syndrome, a condition in which the integrity of the intestinal barrier is compromised, leading to the leakage of harmful substances into the bloodstream. The relationship between the wrong bacteria in the gastrointestinal tract and leaky gut. The gut microbiota is highly dynamic and can be influenced by various factors, including diet, lifestyle, medications, and stress. Dysbiosis, or an imbalance in the gut microbiota, can contribute to the development of leaky gut syndrome, as well as other gastrointestinal disorders, such as IBD, irritable bowel syndrome, IBS, and celiac disease. The wrong bacteria in the gastrointestinal tract can produce harmful metabolites that can damage the gut epithelium and disrupt the gut barrier. The best way to introduce good bacteria. Food is the best way to introduce good bacteria into the gut, as it provides a natural source of probiotics and prebiotic fiber. Fermented foods, such as yogurt, kefir, sauerkraut, and kimchi, are rich in probiotics and can help to promote gut health. Prebiotic fiber can be found in foods such as garlic, onions, asparagus, and Jerusalem artichoke. Probiotic supplements can also be used to supplement the gut microbiota, but it's important to choose a high-quality supplement that contains a diverse range of bacterial strains. Inulinum plus FOS. Inulinum plus FOS is a type of prebiotic fiber that is derived from chicory root. Inulinum is a type of inulin that is resistant to digestion in the small intestine and can reach the large intestine intact, where it serves as a food source for beneficial gut bacteria. FOS, or fructooligosaccharides, is another type of prebiotic fiber that is also resistant to digestion in the small intestine and can selectively stimulate the growth of beneficial gut bacteria. Best foods to eat for a good gut microbiome. The best foods to eat for a good gut microbiome are those that are rich in fiber, prebiotics, and probiotics. Fermented foods, such as yogurt, kefir, sauerkraut, and kimchi, are natural sources of probiotics, while prebiotic fiber can be found in foods such as garlic, onions, and asparagus. Other fiber-rich foods, such as fruits, vegetables, and whole grains, can also help to promote gut health. The role of gut bacteria in processing chemicals such as artificial sweeteners. While gut bacteria play a crucial role in processing many substances, including certain chemicals like artificial sweeteners, their ability to do so is not always a good thing for our health. Artificial sweeteners, such as aspartame, sucralose, and saccharin, are not digestible by the human body and can lead to negative effects on the gut microbiota, potentially contributing to metabolic dysfunction. While these low-calorie sugar substitutes may seem like a healthier option, research suggests that their impact on gut health and overall health may be far from beneficial. The role of the vagus nerve. The vagus nerve plays a critical role in the bidirectional communication between the gut and the brain, and stress can disrupt this connection and lead to gut dysfunction and a range of gastrointestinal symptoms and disorders. The vagus nerve is responsible for regulating gut motility, gut-brain axis function, and immune function, and is activated through various mechanisms such as breathing techniques, meditation, and other relaxation techniques. The impact of stress on gut health. Stress can have a significant impact on gut health, as it can disrupt the gut-brain axis and lead to a range of gastrointestinal symptoms and disorders. Stress can increase gut permeability, alter gut microbiota composition, and lead to intestinal inflammation. Chronic stress has also been linked to the development of various gastrointestinal disorders, such as IBD, IBS, and gastroesophageal reflux disease, GERD. In conclusion, it is clear that gut bacteria diversity is crucial for promoting optimal health and preventing various diseases and disorders. The health of our gut microbiome is influenced by various factors, including the immune system, stress levels, and diet. A diverse range of beneficial gut bacteria, balanced immune function, and a healthy gut-brain axis are all necessary for maintaining optimal gut health. Moreover, postbiotics, short-chain fatty acids, and prebiotics can help promote gut healing and reduce the risk of leaky gut syndrome. We encourage you to consider incorporating prebiotic-rich foods and supplements into your diet and practicing stress management techniques to maintain a healthy gut microbiome. Finally, we hope that the resources we've shared here will help you further explore the world of gut health and its many benefits. Thank you for taking the time to explore the world of gut bacteria diversity with us. We hope that you found this video informative and insightful. If you enjoyed this video, please consider supporting our channel by liking and subscribing to our content. Your support helps us continue to create informative videos like this. We have a selection of informative videos on a range of digestive health topics, including how to unlock relief from diverticulitis with these 9 foods. Home remedies for acid reflux, the top signs of a digestive enzyme deficiency, and how to get rid of peptic ulcers at home. If you're interested in learning more about any of these topics, please feel free to click on the thumbnails on the screen to access these additional resources. We appreciate your interest in our content, and we hope you find these videos informative and helpful. Thanks again, and we look forward to sharing more exciting content with you in the future.